tea given by holy man in 1980s, this will blow you away. The presidency of Donald J. Trump is like no other that we have seen in modern times. The fact that he was elected is somewhat a miracle, considering the evil globalist enemies that worked so hard to have Hillary Clinton defeat him at all costs. Now, a little-known prophecy has been recovered, which was given by a Christian holy man back in the 1980s, and it was Melania Trump who just fulfilled part of what this mystic predicted. This will blow your mind. About 17 years ago, Father Giacomo Capoverde shared a story about his travels, where he was directed by his American doctor friend to visit the House of Loreto, which has been scientifically proven to be from the 1st century, Nazareth. It is believed to be the house where the Virgin Mary received the Archangel Gabriel's message that she was with child. Father Capoverde went into that in some detail, but his main point of his story actually has to do with Donald Trump. Father Giacomo Capoverde shares a fascinating story of his encounter with the Hermit of Loreto, the author of the Pietà prayer book, at the site of the Holy House of the Blessed Virgin Mary, exterior and interior shown in this article's photo. In this video, Father Capoverde shares an amazing premonition this Hermit of Loreto had all the way back in the 1980s about Donald J. Trump, reports Father Heilman. In Loreto, Father Giacomo Capoverde met with an American man named Thomas Zimmer who had given up everything and moved to Loreto where he devoted the rest of his life to prayer. He became known as the Hermit of Loreto. Zimmer relayed that he had had a premonition about a coming leader who would lead America back to God. He told the priest it was Donald Trump, which made the priest laugh. But, Zimmer wasn't laughing, he said he knew what he saw. To authenticate that this actually happened over 20 years ago, Father Giacomo Capoverde's friend, who had advised him to visit the hermit, had Trump's name engraved on a plaque and placed on the Vatican's holy doors, which are only opened in Jubilee years. Trump's name was added in the year 2000, 17 years ago, and Capoverde's friend relates Zimmer told him about Trump during the 1980s. It hit Father Giacomo Capoverde when he accidentally caught Trump's rally when Melania came out and led the nation in the Our Father. Now, some people may think Trump's not a really a big or good Christian. That matters not to God, Trump's roots are in Christianity, and he identifies as one. Whether he prays or not is not any of our business, although I'd bet he bends the knee now with the weight of the world on his shoulders. There's another prophecy made by an Italian man that is starting to make sense, yet, in an ominous way. Bruno Cornacchiola was also a holy man who had dreams about the future. Speaking of one dream in November 1986, he writes, "I see priests and religious men and women all line up while their captors push them, dragging them one by one to a wooden stage. They had them kneel and ask them to get rid of their robes, symbolic for denying your faith. At their answer no. They took their head and put it on a chopping block and there they were beheaded by an executioner who had an axe." Seems pretty much like what we see with the jihadis today. So, was Trump appointed by God? Well, as Christians, we know that all power and authority here on earth is given by God. He allows evil men to rule, just as he appoints just men in times of distress. We already passed through one huge crisis with North Korea, and Trump held tight and refused to give in like the weak leaders in the past. If one thing is clear, we should all really make an effort to pray for him daily. Our country is divided from within, and our enemies surround us. President Trump may just be the man who will have to save us from destruction. Thank you for watching this video. What do you think about this? Share this on Facebook and Twitter along with your comments.